Welcome back to Roadrunner Dex. I'm Dex, and today we're playing Ark Survival Ascended. We're back on the island, and we're in the portion of the island known as the Maw, which is sort of the center of the map. It's kind of a crossroads. There's all kinds of dangers here. There's Dilos, there's Raptors, there's Carnos and Rexes, lots of Argies, all kinds of stuff that kind of go through here. It's a great place, so you can hear something's coming through and we're fighting. It's a great place to build a base just because it's very centrally located and it's easy to get around the map from here. It's great for as an HQ for when you're trying to go drop hunting, and we have a few more days, I think, of Raptor Claws. Actually, maybe tomorrow's the last day, but or today if you're watching this video on Monday. Obviously, that's when it drops. I think that might be the last day. I'd have to check. Anyways, this is a great spot for a base. So let's get going. We're going to keep going with the space. Okay, excuse the voice. My throat has been really bad lately. The last couple days. It should be good, I think, the next couple days. So, let me get these guys to stop following. There was an abominable snowman. You know, they're all level 250, not too far from my base, so I brought everything that would follow me to come and kill it, and it took out both of the little baby Carnos that we had adopted, or whatever you want to call it, and it did a number on this Rex. This Rex is so close to being dead, it's not even funny. So I'm just going to take all the meat. We're going to kill these, raptors. Try not to let these things kill this Rex. This thing is about dead from the abominable snowman. For some reason, I can't get a lock on the raptor. It won't let me use the period button to kill it. So I don't know what's going on exactly there. I thought once it attacks, it would, There we go. Must have had to hit one of the other guys first. Ooh. This guy is hurt bad. If it wouldn't have been for this Mastercraft saddle, I'm sure he'd be dead right now. I mean, these Rexes are just straight tame. They were not imprinted, they're not bred. So it's those snowmen are no joke. I think you're gonna have to start breeding something, maybe the fairies, in order to. We need to start breeding something in order to take those guys on if they get close to the base again. So I thought I'd start recording just because that was such a crazy situation. I should have recorded while we were fighting the snowman, but man, it was just right into the fight and didn't even think about it, to be honest. Okay, excuse the voice. My throat has been really bad lately. Last couple days, it should be good, I think, the next couple days. So let me get these guys to stop following. There was an abominable snowman. You know, they're all level 250, not too far from my base, so I brought everything that would follow me to come and kill it, and it took out both of the little baby Carnos that we had adopted, or whatever you want to call it. And it did a number on this Rex. This Rex is so close to being dead, it's not even funny. Got a little greedy, grabbed a package. I should have just stayed on my, when I got back on my Pteranodon. But so I got taken out by an RG and a couple wolves. So yeah, we're gonna go back and get them and collect our body and collect our stuff. Yeah. Okay. Play. Thank you. I don't know why. Oh no, I said some. Sorry, I said somebody mad. I was talking about this giant Rex. Sorry. No. It's got a baby with it. It's a T-Rex mom and a baby. So if I tame the mom, I can just give food to the baby, and the baby becomes mine too. We're gonna get our beaver out of here. Put him over here. That looks like trouble. Locking my guy in here. Okay, and then what we're gonna do is we're gonna take. I'm gonna leave that one there. Take that. Trying to remember how this would have went in in Ascended or in Evolved, but you know, sorry, my throat is obviously a little messed up still. I'm trying to remember how this would have went in Evolved. I feel like some of this would have collapsed, and they just did so much better with Ascended when they redid these building pieces. So pretty happy about that. Yeah, we're gonna leave that go. Because I feel like this definitely would have... I feel like it would have collapsed when we took out those walls, probably, but... we would at least have to have had... Maybe we still will put in a triangle piece. If I'd have put a triangle piece in, then the roofs... Then the roofs would have done that, but they wouldn't. I think in the old version, it wouldn't allow those vertical pieces on top of the slanted roof like that. Okay, we need to get more wood, but we're pretty heavy, so we gotta drop some stuff first. So you can kind of see what we're doing, get an idea of what we're doing there. If I put a triangle piece... Actually, if I just put a triangle piece in there, maybe it would be faster. Maybe we'll do this side. I'll pull those roofs up, those ceilings up. We'll just throw a triangle piece in that corner and go across with the slanted roof pieces and then see if it'll allow us just to put a vertical piece on there. Thank you. this thing should be about done. So far, it's used 4 exceptional kibble. So I'm used to taming rates where whatever its preferred kibble would be, it would only take 4 total at max level, but I haven't turned them. I try to keep things as close to normal as possible. I only turned up the taming rates just to make things more exciting, because it's not fun just sitting here watching this guy's food go down. There she goes. Got it. All right. Woo. Just making sure I was recording that. All right. Where are those 2 other numbnuts at? Okay, that's what we need for now.
Creepy.
So our cabin, I don't know, mansion, our big base in this clearing here is coming together pretty well, and you'll see it coming into the clearing here. It's based off of a design I saw on Instagram of someone that did a Minecraft base. But it's a little bit different, obviously, and I'm just still trying to figure out how I want to trim it off and kind of decorate. And the insides are just basically wide open. There is nothing. Let's kill this guy quick. As I was saying, the insides are very sparse, so... Okay, we have our base pretty much done, so let's take a look at it here. We'll do a walkthrough. Here's the outside. If you've seen the picture that I was referencing, it doesn't look much like the picture. Just because as we went, you know, things change and you kind of put your own spin on things. But anyways, so here's the front. We have the sort of gardens, landscaping, whatever you want to call it, in the front. So we've got our beds here. They're mostly fed by rainwater, but we put taps there anyways. And we have these We got these water tanks that do catch and distribute rain water to all those things. We've got the pens. Let's open this up. So we're keeping most of our dinos safe in here. We've got an area set up where these guys drop their xenosaur eggs, obviously. There's a male and he's surrounded by females. They drop eggs, and the Oviraptor in here catches them and basically collects the eggs for us, and then we use those for kibble. They provide the second highest tier kibble. We'll get another Oviraptor when we start collecting and raising Uteranuses, which will give us the highest tier kibble. We've got some of our harvesting dinos down here. We found an Ovis, so we want to tame him up. So we got her. Here's the main floor. This is going to be sort of the kitchen area. We're going to get rid of this stuff right here. We're going to put an industrial cooker in right here. But we're leaving it for now until we have that finished. We've got a lot of dinos over here that we use for harvesting. I don't like to keep those too close to the sort of living area, which is going to be right here. So I'm going to kind of partition this off. It's not going to be a full wall, just sort of a partitioned wall maybe. Here, we have easy access to the power generator for the entire base. Let's see. This is going to get moved around. We're not going to have these. We'll probably have one or two more of these, and we'll also have, obviously, some refrigerators over here. And we'll decorate this with different things, trophies, and whatever we can find. This is the upper level. It's obviously meant to look down on what's going on up there. This is supposed to be sort of the fun, kind of chill area. Watch the sunrises from over there. And I'll arrange this a little bit better to be sort of a bedroom. And we'll decorate this with probably artifacts, and we'll decorate the walls with trophies, which will be the boss heads and Alpha T-Rex heads, obviously. And then up here is sort of the workshop. We've already got our chemistry bench, which we basically farmed a lot of silica pearls in order to turn into electronics to get that. So that's done. Fabricator's done. The grinder will probably go right here. We've got these set up for now, and we'll probably leave those set up just because they look kind of cool. We have our forges here, right underneath our secret doors. When we're harvesting resources, we drop our dinos right onto this ledge here, and then we can easily access them and put their things in these storage bins and storage containers, and we can also put the metal inside the forges there. And then the last little area is the garden. So this is an enclosed greenhouse, obviously. The fertilizer will last longer, the crops will last longer. Everything is better inside the greenhouse, so we have that on here. And we also have, obviously, collected a beehive. The beehive that we collected from the redwoods we put in here, just because it's kind of a cool little centerpiece. And then we have some more rainwater containers up here. We didn't run any pipes or any intakes to that river that's down there. All we did was use enough of the water containers. They give us plenty of water for our purposes. So the base is pretty much done, other than some details, trim work. We're probably going to add a back door right here. That way we can access it from the bottom. And I may add small doors, like regular double wide doors on each side there. We'll have to see. If I do that, I'll probably move this grill. But yeah, that's the base. It's pretty much done. It can be kind of a pain in the butt to build here because there's so much going on. There are so many dinos that sneak in. They will literally walk right up those steps and into your base and start attacking your stuff. So that's why we fenced all this off. We like those trees, so we put the fences around those trees. We got our taming pen with a fairly high level Ankylosaurus. I don't know if we need it, but we have it if we want it. And we'll probably put some foundations down and have sort of a breeding area right there. But otherwise, it's done. I like the look of it. I'm pretty happy with it. Well, we need to add lights, ambiance, and some decoration to it, but otherwise it's pretty much done. So that's it. All right, that's the base. Thanks for watching. If you guys liked the video, hit the like button. If you want to see more, hit the subscribe button. And go ahead and leave comments. We can name some of these dinos. And if you got any suggestions for decoration or how to sort of finish out this base, I'd love to hear it. Yeah, thanks guys. See you in the next one.